chapter 4, it deals with affidavits. What is the value of an affidavit? Why people say anything to be submitted by way of affidavit? Even in some colleges or in courts, the judges will say, file an affidavit. Why? Why they are not saying file an application? We will tell about it. The word affidavit in this chapter shall include any document required to be sworn. And the words swear and sworn shall include affirm and affirmed. So, if a document is required to be sworn and the words swear and sworn shall include affirm and affirmed. So, affidavit is an inclusive definition given. The word affidavit in this chapter shall include any document required to be sworn. If a document is required to be sworn, then, and the words swear and sworn shall include affirm and affirmed. This is very simple. So, next question is, how you make a sworn statement in an affidavit? 35 says, the form of affidavit should be like this. You have to write in the first person, I. The person who is making that affidavit, he must say that it is he who is doing it. Not in third person, he, she, or like that. The person who is the deponent must write in first person, I am doing this. I gave this money. I am instructed. Like that, in that first person way, he must write in the affidavit in paragraph wise. And each paragraph, as nearly as may be, shall be confined a distinct portion of the subject. Each para must contain a distinct portion of the subject. You can't make four or five subjects in one para. In one para, a distinct portion of the subject you have to mention. This is how you have to prepare affidavit. Like suppose you went to Hyderabad and there you spent for 10 days. Then you went to Tirupati, there you spent for 10 days. Like that you went to different places. If you feel that this all is a distinct portion of the subject, then you must keep everything in one para. Or if you feel that Hyderabad is separate trip and Tirupati is separate trip, it is a different distinct portions of the subject, you must write in the affidavit by mentioning separate portions, separate paras of distinct portions of the subject. So, you must give affidavits in writing. They must be either typed or printed and stitched bookwise. The defendant shall sign at the foot of the each of the page of the affidavit. So, affidavit should be like a book form. You can't give leave pages. All should be stitched like a book form, one after another, and it should be stitched, and they must be, the affidavit must be only written, not typed or printed, and stitched bookwise. Each page of the affidavit shall be signed by the person who is making the affidavit. For forms of oath and affirmation, refer the schedule to the Indian Oaths Act 1969. How you have to do and all that is there and oath and affirmation, it is there in that Indian Oaths Act 1969. Then rule 36, description of deponent. Every person making an affidavit shall describe, subscribe his full name, name of his father, his age, place of residence, and his trade or occupation. But generally, in all affidavits you will see, the age of the caste of the deponent also is written. But this particular rule 36 clearly says, you must mention full name, father name, age, place of residence, and his trade or occupation. You need not mention caste. Then, title of affidavits. In the title of affidavit, you must mention in which suit you are filing that affidavit. How many plaintiffs are there, defendants there? It shall be sufficient to state the full name of the first plaintiff or defendant, respectively. And there are other plaintiffs or defendant as the case may be. In affidavits, in the cause title, you need not mention the names of all parties. Just simply, plaintiff number one, you may mention the first plaintiff and six others. In defendants also, defendant number one name and six other defendants. This is enough. So, who before whom you can sworn the affidavit is rule number 38. Who are the officers before whom you can sworn is rule number 38. Then statement of officer before whom the affidavit is sworn. The officer who before whom we have sworn it, he must make a statement to that effect. If there are any interrelations or alterations, then there is a procedure of the person making interrelations, making signature in the and mentioning the note. Suppose by mistake, some type of mistake is there, if you made a correction or interpolation or alteration, you must mention the same at the end and note it, and the person who is making that corrections, he must sign there. Suppose the officer before whom you are making the affidavit sworn, he doesn't know the person making the affidavit personally, then he must get that person identified through proper person. The procedure under section rule 42 in respect of Pardhan Action women, blind or illiterate person. Suppose an illiterate person is there or a blind person is there, he does not know how to make an affidavit, how to sworn, then the procedure is there, explaining by bringing a person who is acquainted with that language, that is blind person, illiterate person or some other language known person. They are the persons who are giving affidavit. You must get the person who is qualified or acquainted with that person, and through them you can get it sworn. You must note also in the same. Suppose if he is having physical deformity or there is any other cause due to which he cannot understand the language, he cannot give an affidavit, so he cannot put signature, then you must mention at the end that the contents of the affidavit were read over and explained to the deponent and admitted by him to be correct. This statement you must make a mention in it. Then rule 44, before any affidavit is used it shall be filed into court, but the judge may, the contest or both parties are in case of urgency, allow any affidavit to be presented to the court and read on the hearing of the application. When an affidavit is prepared, you must file it in the court. But the judge has got discretion to file it at the time of arguments, at the time of hearing. So then notice must be given about filing of affidavit. How? Not less than 2 days notice generally. You have to file that affidavit into court. Proper endorsement, without proper endorsement, you can't file affidavits. Description of the
person.
You prepared the affidavit today. Other side notice you must give 2 days in advance. Hearing is on 16th. By 14th you must give notice and file it into the court. Or the court may permit you to file it at the time of hearing. Both. Generally speaking, 2 days in advance you must give copy of the affidavit to other side, so that he prepares. Affidavit also must contain information regarding and also belief about some of the statements, whether he got through information or it is his belief. If it is a matter of his opinion, suppose if somebody is giving an opinion, then he must mention by stating this is my opinion. When he is giving opinion, he must clearly mention what is his experience in that subject, how he is acquainted with the person or matter as to whom the opinion is expressed, or other means of knowledge of the deponent. I am giving an opinion stating some X has got the habit of drinking. So for my giving my opinion, I must say clearly length of my experience or acquaintance with that person. From how long I know about his drinking, and also how he is acquainted with that person. All those things. If there is scandalous matter, as per rule 50, the court can sumato or on application stuck it up. Suppose an affidavit is filed abusing the other side, then other side can file an application, sorry, he abused me, please strike it out. That is not needed to be here. Likewise, you can ask in that way. So the court may documents referred to in exhibit in affidavit. Document referred to by affidavit shall be referred to as exhibits and shall be marked in the same manner as exhibits admitted by the court, and shall bear the certificate in form number 16, which shall be signed by the officer before whom the affidavit is taken. So you are filing a chief affidavit. That's called a witness has come. He wants to give evidence. His evidence is given by way of affidavit. So he is referring about the documents. He must mention the description of documents at the fag end by stating these are the documents which I am seeking to mark on my behalf. By stating so, he must request the court for marking those documents. Then court will put a certificate in form number 16 on that document which are going to be marked. Thereafter we have got cross examination on affidavit. Rule 52 says the court may at any time direct that any person shall attend to be cross examined on his affidavit. This is important. You filed affidavit. The court can order at the request of the other side, yes, call that person to be cross-examined for cross-examination purpose, because the truth or otherwise of the contents in the affidavit can be examined. So that is the chapter. Today